Okay, we're going to look at this camp stove toaster. I've had this for, I don't know, like 20 years, maybe almost 30 years. I don't know. I got it when I was a kid, and I'm not sure if we even had a camp stove then. I don't really know why I got this, but anyway. But it's, I've never used it. It's the Koglins brand. Let's see, heavy steel plate, won't warp, coated wires, won't rust, folds flat for easy storage, features shore grip wire toaster holders. I guess that's a little part here. Let's see, so you lift up the frame, use toaster on main burner of your gas stove. Let's see. Operate stove full open. That's kind of weird. Wait 2 or 3 minutes for toaster to get hot, then place bread on the frames. So it's, I guess, supposed to toast the bread from the heat that comes out of the metal itself, instead of, you're not like actually toasting it from like the flame of the from the gas stove, which is, you can see it was a bit of rust on this. Sitting around so long, so I steel wool that off, but so your little things where your bread will sit. You can fold it up here. Push it like this, and then you can tuck one of these under or something to hold it, because it was folded up when it was in the box, and I don't really, but I think you're supposed to tuck one of these under one of these other ones here or something to, so it stays, but whatever, but you can fold it fairly flat. But, anyway. It's a little bit bent up. I've been kicking around here for years. We had like a big box of stuff that we had for like camping things from the old days, and this was like always in it. And it just never got used though. This just says made in, it says Canada on it, so that's kind of, you know, it's not new. So this is made in Canada. 1987, I guess that's when this type of box came out. It was from Home Hardware. I don't, the price is ripped off, but so I don't know how much it was. I think they're about like $7 now on Amazon, like the Coleman brand, which I suspect they're made in China now. But anyway, so we're going to fire up the gas, so we're going to try to toast one piece of bread. I don't want four. You can put four on it. I think some people say that it works better with four because it, you know, it gets like a chimney effect or something, but I don't want four slices of bread, so I got to live with it. So so if that guy's still lurking around leaving comments, then you know why I'm using one slice. So, anyway, we'll fire it up and see if we can get this to go. Okay, we got the old 421D here. So let's just put it on full blast. Put her on there. In frame, yes we are. Let that heat up, and then we'll sorry, turn it black. Gave this thing a paint job, if you noticed or not. This one had the, it was all silver paint on the inside, which was like hideous. I'm not sure if they wanted to make it, I don't know, reflect the heat better or something. I don't know, but it's just looked terrible. So I got a can of, it's not, I don't know. I guess it's similar sort of Coleman green. It's, I don't know if it's forest green or what it is, but took it all apart. Wire brushed it, and some rust paint on it. As you can see, this is quite a lot lighter, but I think it was painted once before. Like the green part was redone. Like I know they put the silver paint in, but I guess it depends what year on Coleman's, what color they are too, because my newer one is like very dark green. And, So I think this is probably closer to the original color, but I don't know. It's getting warm anyway, the color change. Kind of a pathetic piece of bread. It's like Weight Watchers bread or something. Like. Anyway, I got a piece of corned beef there. Some horseradish mustard. So we'll toast that and slice it in half. She does here. There's all kinds of videos on YouTube of people using these, but most of them they some are doing it right, but not that I'm doing it right here. We'll see. Yeah, I shouldn't talk first. I should. Kind of reminds me, years ago we were on vacation, like years ago, and I was like, I don't know, 5 years old or something, I remember it. And the hotel had like these cottages thing kind of things you stayed in, and they had one of those old style toasters with the sides that folded down. Kind of neat. I've always wondered, it'd be kind of cool to find one of them, but I think you could probably fix up old ones. I imagine the core to be gone on most of them, but they're well known for burning toast because getting home. Maybe it does need four slices to work properly. I don't know, whatever. I'll work with it. Seems like a lot of work to toast one piece of one piece of bread. There's one guy's video, he's showing how to bought one, and it was all like the little metal things were all off of it, the wires. He was trying to put it together, and I think he put it together wrong because he had like the, because he got these two here, they go over top, and then these other ones they go under, and he had them like one up and one down, and like he's like, there, that's how it works, and you see that it wasn't locking together like it should lock together in those little bumps, like bumps there or whatever. And I was like, and everybody in the comments were like, oh, thanks a lot, buddy. There, I guess. Yeah. A little toast going on. This one's high, isn't really, it's not too bad, I guess. But see how much the bread tastes like Coleman fuel here, too. I think the road is too busy now. How long it takes the toast? It's like 5 or 10 minutes to toast one piece of bread. Still, it works, I guess. But the healthiest thing ever, too. Let's toast our bread over white gas. It's probably. This stove's great though. This one we've taken in the woods the last while, and it's, we cooked, you know, we cooked spaghetti last time. We cooked, we had bratwurst sausages or whatever one time. We had, what else do we have? We had, we actually used a satellite burner to like, heat up. Yeah, we had, that's what we had. We had fried spam and like chili with it, or chili and beans mixed together. And we just heated that on the canned stuff, heated on the satellite burner, and it worked good. pretty impressed with this whole thing. I think this thing's like late 60s, early 70s. I think, because it's a Canadian model, but it's, I think they said this model was replaced in 1977 or something like that, but anyway. And the tank is from like 1960, but it's for the older one I got, but it's, I gotta buy a couple of those kits and get the fill cap for them, because the other ones are the two-piece and they both leak, so I think I'll just buy a couple of the single-piece ones and replace them and be done with it, instead of trying to replace the gaskets in them and stuff. Because I have two other tanks, but there was a red tank that went with this, is actually the, I don't know. There. Oh yeah, that's that's not too bad. That's how crispy you want your bread, I guess. Or how toasted you want your toast. Enough, actually, it's pretty thin. Pretty thin stuff, anyway. So. It does work pretty well, though. Kind of cool to get one of those little Coleman ovens or whatever. But. It's kind of funny, if you noticed on the picture on the box, it's pretty much faked big time, because there's no lines on the toast, you notice in the picture, like that were caused by the wires. So it's kind of like, it's like, okay, so you're kind of like a McDonald's hamburger that's basically all made out of plastic or painted or something to make it look good. But it's, geez, toasting fairly well. It's not, you know, have 9 minutes. But, you know. Anyway, so that's probably enough. Turn that off. Smell like camp fuel, I guess. Yeah, it tastes all right. I'm not getting any weird flavors out of it too much or anything. I think it's just this bread. I don't know, this White Watchers bread is kind of like this. Yeah, it works.